It's been 3 years since Genshin Impact Story and Lore has been running. We, as the travelers from the outside world, already traveled across 4 nations, and yet we still find nothing about Paimon. As the mascot of the game and the closest person Travel has, it is kinda weird how little we know about her. But how many of us really know about Paimon? So today, we are going to talk everything we know about Paimon and every theory related to her. Plus, how it is so hard for us to uncover her identity. Well, let's begin with her appearance. Despite her small body as a fairy, Paimon has a pretty unique dress that really resembled theme to the complete version of the Statue of the Seven. Not only that, almost all the animation she has is surrounded by the stars, which is similar to Dance Slave motif and Traveler Idol animation. What is even more interesting is that, if I remember correctly, she is the only character model so far to have a tiara hovering over her head. Tiara itself is another version of the crown, which is associated with queens, noblewomen, and the bride. One thing that most of us always pay attention to is the symbols attached to her, inverted triquetra and star dark blue hairpin, which is apparently the most appealing symbol of divinity in the world of Teyvat. Speaking of divinity, the name Paimon itself is a demon name from Ars Goetia, the same sort used for Archon's name in Genshin. So, does it mean Paimon is similar to Archon? Not really. Despite their different appearance, Paimon in Ars Goetia and Paimon in Genshin have similar traits. Like, they are pretty knowledgeable, good at explaining things, have a crown, love treasures, loyal to Lucifer, and are able to create all kinds of things. And because of this connection, later on it slowly becomes a reference for Genshin lore enthusiasts whenever they making theories about Paimon. I know it is not that important, but Paimon is only wearing a stocking on her right leg. Beside that, it is still a question as to why no one in Teyvat recognized Paimon, including Archon, despite the fact that most of them saw and called Paimon in 22 different aliases, as if she were a fairy. This might suggest people in Teyvat subconsciously know about Paimon's existence. Well, with all those unique things, surely she has an interesting personality that everyone likes, right? Unfortunately, among our community, there are many people who dislike Paimon. The common reasons are that she is too loud and has immature demeanor. But in any case, she is still the number one person who sincerely cares about travelers' life and wishes. We can see this on many occasions, even in critical moments. Paimon is still with the travelers. The most phenomenal one is where the traveler fainted for a moment when receiving the Raiden Shogun's attack, and there, Paimon panicked and kept trying beside her no matter what. So, she might be slightly annoying for us, but in game lore, she is the only person that keeps traveler's sanity along the journey. Moving on to her personal side. Believe it or not, she is actually kinda smart. This is proven by her ability to summarize a very difficult description. Even though, on several occasions, she gives us pretty questionable responses. But I think it is fine. We all know together she loves eating, especially slime products. But at the same time, she is really afraid of living slimes. Heck, she even gets nightmares because of it. Then it raises a question as to why is she afraid of slime? There is a theory among the CN community that suggests a few reasons for Paimon being so childish, greedy for quality foods and treasures. Paimon, similar to Guoba, lost her powers and memories turning into a tiny fairy. But unlike Guoba, who was adopted early on by Xiangling, Paimon need to struggle to survive in the wilderness at the first place, always fearing being attacked by larger creatures like slime and hillagers. She lives off leftover food and berries, constantly trying to avoid danger. But over time, she then tried to face a bigger opponent and was failing, flung into the water. Later on, our MC rescued her from the water and became her guardian. Eventually, Paimon learned to enjoy things she used to fear, eating delicious food and collecting shiny objects as a distraction to hide from things that might eat her. This would also probably explain why she would occasionally have nightmares of being eaten by something bigger than her. Unfortunately, it also means that being separated from the MC probably gives Paimon PTSD from the difficult times that she was trying to survive in the wilderness all alone. Man, if this theory about Paimon's past was indeed true, then it is such a sad story. Okay, we have enough with her personality. How about her ability so far? If I remember correctly, Paimon at the very least has two major abilities or powers that we have witnessed, namely flying or floating, whatever you call it, and ability to instantly disappear out of thin air. These two abilities are actually pretty common in the world of Teyvat. There are several creatures that can float without any trouble, let's say Pari, Endora, and the Genie Battle. And for instant disappearing, even Tanuki in Inazuma can do that. The difference is that Paimon disappearance lasts a bit longer. Besides Dust 2, we haven't seen any potential ability she probably has. So overall, there's nothing really special about Paimon's ability, which is kinda disappointing. Since we have talked about everything we know about Paimon, it is time to compile every theory that tries to uncover her identity based on information mentioned before. After some diving into the community, there are at least 12 different Paimon theories, which I have already discussed in 3 different videos a long time ago, and I believe most of you already know this. The list includes Unknown God, God of Time, Silly, Moon Sister, Paimoria One, One of the Shades, Celestia's Puppet, Teyvat Avatar, Travel Power, Project Paimon, Starkeeper, and a Program. In summary, most of the Paimon theory involves around 3 things. Either she is the divine, she is a tool, or she is not from Teyvat. Until this moment, none of the theories so far ever reached a clear conclusion. Or rather, there is no solid and clear confirmation in-game. Basically, we are not going anywhere, even after we get in the halfway of the game story, which is frustrating. The reason behind this is that Hoyoverse seems to not give enough room to Paimon, whether character development or bit-by-bit information about her, like from her past memories or action and feelings she has during the quest. I know it is hard to say, but to be fair, Paimon feels like a blank character. What I mean is, we don't understand her perspective as the player, her motivation, her goal, some kind of attachment to her. We don't really have that in deep emotion. We only know that she is like foods, fear of being abandoned, and mastering an ugly nickname. Besides dust, there is nothing left. There is no such motivation to make us feel empathy for her. This is always making me question Hoyoverse. If Paimon is really important and central character for the world building of the lore and story, then at the very least, give her room to recollect and slowly share her memories and perspective of the world. We can call it as a character progression. Or let the characters in the game question the existence of Paimon. Not just for once, but for a couple of times. I know that Albedo ever asked for it, but they never brought it up again. Well, I understand that Hoyoverse want to make Paimon as an enigma, and just being the mascot of the game and guide for the traveler. But if one day Paimon turns out to be like plot twist villain or some kind of divine or important person in Teyvat or even die, I believe most of us would not impress or take deep emotion because of that lack of understanding. That is also probably why, after almost 3 years, many players assume Paimon has nothing to do with the grand plan of the lore and story. It is really unfortunate indeed. I personally hope Hoyoverse puts more progression into Paimon, not just her personality, but also her backstory. Regardless about that ranting, in my opinion, Paimon is the divine, it's the most possible theory that's reaching the truth, which can be confined into 3 pieces, such as, number 1, Paimon being a deity who's born from many as like Pari, number 2, Paimon being the original god, and number 3, Paimon being the part of some divine or perceived to be divine, as like Silly, Adaptus, Yokai, etc., etc. Because all the hints we have till this time bring us to those conclusions. I don't know what Hoyoverse intends to do, but let's see what they are gonna cook. So what do you think? Do you have any theories regarding Paimon? Or do you also have the same problem with the most of the players, not fully understanding Paimon? please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, Hello Zen here, and see you next time!